Welcome to this video. In this video, I would like to show and explain you the four help. In my opinion, it is one of the most important helps in the whole SAP system, so in SAP ERP and SAP S/4HANA. You can use the four help to find the information you need in SAP ERP and SAP S/4HANA. I also would like to show you a little trick that can increase your efficiency within the SAP system. So watch this video till the end. Enjoy this video and let's get started. F4 help. Find the needed information in the SAP system. The F4 or search help is one of the most frequently used search functions in SAP ERP and SAP S/4HANA. It is called S4 help because it is executed using the F4 key on your keyboard. It is used to display possible input parameters within the SAP system. To use it, click with the mouse button in an input field and press the F4 key or the magnifying glass to the right of the input field. Either a list of possible values opens directly or a more detailed search to find the desired values. So now I would like to show you the F4 help directly in the SAP system. So here, for example, we are in the transaction code FBL1N to display vendor line items. And in here, as described, we have an input field where on the right side, we can see the magnifying glass, the loop icon. And in here, you can hit either the F4 key on your keyboard or click on this button to open up the F4 help. And in here, basically, you can search for available values and entries for this specific input field based on different search terms. So for example, here, based on a search term for a country, for a postal code, a city, Wayne, name, a vendor, or what you like to. If you click on this button on the top right corner, there you can open up different search fields, what you like to. So for example, you can search the vendors by country or company or what you like to. So for example, if I don't limit the search, I have just limit the search up to 500 entries. And if I click on the start search button, then here all the available entries for the vendor input field are shown. And with double click, I can take over the ID of the vendor. Because basically, if we're not using the F4 key, you have type in manually the needed information. So in this case, if you know the vendor account by heart, then you can type it in manually, that's for sure. But here, basically, you can search for other well-known parameters. So for example, for the name, for the city, or what you like to. And what I really, because now we open up this for help once again, we can see different available vendors. And for example, I would like to show you a really nice trick using the F4 help. Because if you here, for example, you have to type in directly the shown search term. For example, here we have different search terms starting with leave. So for example, if I type in leave and then 81, hit the enter, then those two vendors are shown based on this search term. And if I'm not sure what kind of suffix is or what kind of characters are there, you can use a really nice trick. You can use an asterisk. And for example, if I type in leaf and then a star, an asterisk, and then hit the enter key or click on the start search button, then all the vendors will be shown where they have a search term starting with leaf. So in this case, leaf 2, leaf 6, and whatever. You can do the other way around. So for example, if you're not sure what kind of prefix is there in the search term, you can do the other way around. So you can just type in whatever, so asterisk, and then for example, 8, and then once again an asterisk. So all the windows will be displayed where there are some characters, multiple characters, whatever, and then an 8, and then different characters. So at least where there is an 8 in the search term. And then if I once again execute this, now we're seeing all the vendors where there is an 8. So here is an 8. We can see on every search term an 8. And for example, if we would like to show all the vendors ending with an 8, we can just delete the asterisk, execute the search once again. And here we have two vendors where in the search term there's an 8 at the end. If you want to, and if you're not sure, so for example, we have some leaf 8 and then 1 single character, then you can just use the plus sign and then execute the search, because now all the vendors are shown were in the search term starting with leaf 8 and then 1 single character. Doesn't matter what kind of character, 1 single character. And then we again, with double click, you can take over the ID of this vendor. And if you would like to fasten up and would like to use the F4 help more efficiently, then you can just, if you open up the F4 help, and then you can use the equal sign directly in the input field. And here, for example, you have to keep in mind that the equal sign is using the first input field in the previously selected F4 help. In that case, it's the first input field in the F4 help is the search term. And with the equal sign, we're using this input field. So for example, we have the search term, and here we would like to search for vendors starting with leaf, and for example, 8, whatever, and then hit the enter key on your keyboard. There we're seeing all the vendors starting with leaf 8, and it puts, as we're seeing in here, an asterisk on its own. So you don't need to put an asterisk at the end. It is adding this on its own. It's really useful. And then with double click, you can take this over quite easily. And I would like to show you once again a little trick. We have one vendor with this search term. And if you have just one single entry in the available F4 help, it will put automatically the ID of the found entry. So in here, if we're using enter and then the search term and then hit enter, then directly, yeah, okay, we have some error warnings based on the ID, but basically, as we've seen, the ID of this vendor has been put automatically into this field. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you have enjoyed this video. If you have any questions, leave them in the comment sections. Please hit the like button and subscribe this YouTube channel to never miss great upcoming videos. Thank you very much, and then see you in the next video.